The acronym ERP stands for Enterprise Resource Planning. An ERP system is a core enterprise software and solution stack comprised of a central database surrounded by multiple plug-in services and software packages, each of which is tailored to solve specific enterprise problems and address specific challenges. At the core of all ERP solutions is a master database. This database houses all the records that a company uses within all of its ERP solutions. These records can be financial, like invoices and purchase orders. They can be related to payments, like accounts payable and payroll and taxes. They can be related to inventory status, so that a company knows what its supply lines are and how many of all finished goods are available in every warehouse. That core database also stores all of the sales data, what customers have ordered, what products, as well as details and specifics on the internal processes to get that product from the warehouse to the customer. But simply storing the data by itself isn't useful. The importance of an ERP system is to take all the data that a company collects and use it and integrate it so that that company can find ways to increase efficiency and save on costs. This is why there's always a data analytics piece that wraps around the entirety of that core ERP database. This analytics engine is busy, as it's constantly creating reports on regular schedules and updating the tables themselves, but it also has to have the ability to provide data to users on an ad hoc basis whenever a user has a specific query that they need more information from. So for all that data to flow correctly into the database, and for the core functions of the ERP system to work correctly, let's talk about the most commonly implemented modules that you'll find within an ERP system. So that first module, that's going to be your sales module. That is all of your sales data, your order data, your customer data, so what customers buying what things, where it's going, shipping, tracking, all of the PO information on how it's getting paid for and the payment status. You've got to track all of that sales data. But in order to make sales happen, you've got to have product. And in order to have product, that means that you've got to have procurement. So for procurement, you've got to go out there, you've got to track what materials am I buying? Who am I buying them from? Where are they coming from? Am I getting the best deal? Am I doing all of the things that I need to do to acquire what I need to make my product? But procurement goes so much further than that. It's not just what does it take to make your product. It's also, are you procuring what you need in order for your employees to keep up and running? Are you buying things as complex as servers to go into a data farm and as simple as packages of ballpoint pens so that people have something to sign with? All of those pieces go into that procurement area. And then in addition to the procurement, you've got to have your production systems, right? Production is incredibly important because you have to track that production from the very beginning with your raw materials to the very end with your finished product. And production is going to track everything in between. It's going to do the planning, the capacity management, the maintenance, the materials management, being sure that the right things are being staged at the right place at the right time, particularly as we've moved into this just-in-time manufacturing process everywhere in the world so that we get as much efficiency in our manufacturing process as we can. And so after we finish that procurement, we might have a distribution module. That module is going to be concerned with how do we get our finished products from point A to the customer's door, or just from point A to the loading dock door. So that distribution model, that's going to be warehouse processes and staging goods and movement of finished goods, logistics control, inventory control, stock levels, trigger levels, all of those things that are necessary from a logistics perspective because every business runs with that logistics trail. And so your distribution modules have to keep track of all of that. They've got to run all of it for you or you're just going to run into inefficiencies. And then related to manufacturing and still very important, you've got your asset pieces, right? So you've got your assets and you have to track them. These are fixed assets, capital assets. You have to know everything about them, not just the procedural information. What do you have? Who made it? How does it work? What's its status? Does it have any maintenance coming up? Is it still under a service contract? Those things are important, don't get me wrong, but your finance department is going to insist that you also have all of that finance-related data. What's the valuation of your asset? What's its depreciation status? What is its expected useful life? Should they be planning on a capital expenditure in order to replace it in a certain number of years? Tracking all of that is key to the asset part because, again, this fits in holistically. And so all of these services, these are all the back office ones. Back office is important, but also important is front office. And this is the point where we should cut back to me doing this very nice scripted speech. So let's talk about these front office customer facing or customer touching solutions. Things like customer relationship management software, right? That's your CRM piece. Why does CRM matter? Well, CRM matters because that's everything to do with your relationship to that customer. It's customer information, sales history, it's incoming leads on people who are potentially interested in buying your products, it's opportunity from first identification to opportunity close, it's all of your sales tracking data and your pipeline information that you report out on. All of that goes into that CRM system. That data is essential to knowing the status of your company and knowing what your revenue is going to be as you track all of those opportunities from open to close. And then in addition to your CRM suite, you've also got your Hcm suite, right? Human capital management or HR software. There's lots of different names for it, but the same general idea. How are you going out and sourcing new employees? How are you retaining the ones that you already have? How are you being sure that everybody is being judged appropriately, that annual reviews are going well, that all of the back-end processes necessary to onboard and hire and maintain and pay your employees happen? All of that goes into that Hcm suite. And while that might not necessarily be part of your ERP system, it certainly falls within the umbrella, the larger category, of what ERP is. And so while it might be a tightly coupled system, it might also be integrated in. It really just depends on which one you've picked. And then also another tightly coupled system that may or may not be part of the ERP suite is your accounting system. Now, some companies obviously choose to put their ERP and their accounting software together. Some of them choose to break it apart. But that accounting piece, that is always going to be core because the data from the accounting piece is going to feed back into everything else that you're doing. Likewise, you're going to have finance modules. These are the ones that are more tightly coupled and probably built into the ERP that are going to track all of those things like your company investments, company's financial status. It's going to ingest all of that data we talked about before with your assets and things like that. And it's going to track the financial health of your company at a very high level. And that high level is probably the most important part of your ERP system. Because everything that we've talked about, everything on this wheel right now, this is about running the business from a very operational level. But the next step is not just the operations piece, it's the governance piece. So we're going to remove this database and we're going to remove these analytics engines and we're going to put governance right here in the middle. Because every module that we have, every one of these modules has to feed that data into the holistic governance picture. Because executives at the boardroom level or one step down from the boardroom level, these executives are going to make the decisions that they have to make about the future of the company. These are the strategic level decisions based on inputs from all of the modules within your ERP system. It's how you look at the company health holistically. And that's very different because it's a roll-up of all of the data from all of the modules that are in that, that are feeding into that database. And so as we bring all of this data in, we create this roll-up reporting, we create this summary reporting, we put that into dashboards, right? So that companies can go out and the C-suite can look at a dashboard every morning that's going to show them the holistic health of the company. From every factory they have, to every location they have, every distribution point, what's going on with shipping, what's going on with retail, what's going on with procurement, all of that data feeds into the ERP. And it gives the executives involved the ability to do those strategic level decisions. It's incredibly important. All in all, hopefully I've given you a good overview of what an ERP system is and why it's so critical to the successful operation of any modern company. Your ERP system is always going to be core to your daily operation. And because of that, selecting the right cloud provider for running your ERP system is also critical. Your business is 24/7, 365, and so must be the cloud on which you run it. So if you'd like to talk more about how to implement a new ERP system from the ground up, or how to transition your existing ERP system into a modern one, you can learn more at ibm.com/cloud/SAP, or you can reach out to your IBM sales team or your IBM business partner. And we'd love to engage with you on how to improve your whole company by improving your ERP system.